Alright guys, welcome back to the world tour, and last time we left off and I was throwing an ender pearl into the air. So, the reason I did that is because I wanted to save the ender pearl in the loaded chunks, and I've actually done that now, so we don't have to worry about that. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to run through the end. This is the end, by the way, and you can see where I dug out all the obsidian towers because I actually lit bedrock on fire. On top of where all the obsidian towers used to be, the old ones, because this is an old end. And it gives sort of a cool, like, eerie effect to the end. See, we only have one end gateway at the moment, right over there. And I have found a couple of different end cities, by the way, obviously, since we have the Elytra, I found the end cities. But, yeah, that's why I have all the flaming bedrock. And somehow that one went out. Should not happen. Although maybe I didn't light that one for some reason. But basically, the reason the bedrock is flaming here is because that's where the obsidian towers used to be. Sort of like a testament to the obsidian towers I dug out. But, yeah, this is the end here. Not much to see except for an Enderman farm that is broken, which I'll show you guys in a moment. But first, we're actually going to head back to the overworld. And it looks like we are at... Yeah, so we're now back at Zerzera. Let me go ahead and head to the area I need to be in, which is... my house area. And what we're going to do now is we're going to teleport 800 blocks in an instant. So this is made possible due to the jumper. So the jumper is a teleporter that I constructed here. And this is it. This is what I told you guys way back in episode 1 we would eventually get to. So now we have gotten to it. And we are going to use it. So this actually teleports us right out to the end, basically. So the way it works, if I can just show you here real quick without activating this, the way it works is we have a redstone line that gives you, it should give you a enderpearl here, first of all, but a redstone line that goes all the way out to the end portal. So the minecart ride we just took at the beginning of last episode, that is the distance that this redstone line traverses. And there is sort of a cutoff for this redstone down here, and then it starts to go into some instant repeaters. And you have to use these instant repeaters, otherwise the signal does not work. So, yeah, that's what this is, just the old school manual repeaters with the redstone block, and there's more of these. This just keeps going on and on and on and on and on. I'm not going to go down the whole line because that would take, you know, 10-20 minutes to get all the way down it, but that is what allows us to travel this distance in an instant. So what this line does is it will actually load a 5x5 chunks, 5x5 area of chunks out at the end portal. And since we threw the ender pearl up there and then immediately fell into the portal, we should see that the pearl is still suspended in the air. And that should basically allow us to teleport to the end. So I'll show you my coordinates here, just to prove you there's no shenanigans going on here. So we're at 250, 250 roughly, in X and Z. If I step on these, we will see. Boom. There we go. And I'm glitching out. One second. But yeah, you can see the coordinates. Let me just teleport out. And we are back at the end, over 800 blocks away. So, kind of a cool thing. You can teleport a huge distance in an instant, basically. So, yeah, like I said last time, we're now going to take a look at what this huge thing is here in this map. This might actually need to be updated, actually. Let's just see. Nope, not really. So this is actually something relatively new. Those of you guys who've been watching the channel might be wondering why there's no portal here. And that is because I've actually moved the portal. I'm just going to reset this real quick, by the way. Reset this jumper mechanism. I actually moved the portal, the nether portal, up to the top. So now when we come through via the nether to this area, we actually now will come through inside the giant dragon egg and bedrock block. And so that is what the weird thing is you saw on the map down there. It's actually this thing right here. We got pigs in here for some reason. That's kind of cool. But yeah, this is why I moved this nether portal up here. So essentially what happens now is we come through the nether like this, step out, and this is what we see. We see this end portal. Sort of quote-unquote end portal up here, and this is like supposed to be representative of the void down here. So that is what we got there. Let me show you the outside of this area. So first of all, we have a broken door here I need to fix, but that's beside the point. What I really want to show you is behind me. Let me just get out to a sufficient distance so that we can see this. But this is probably one of about 3 or 4 projects that took an insane amount of time. A couple of the other ones being the arena, the ice farm, and the, what's the other one? The guardian farm. So, boom. There we go. Yep, I made a giant pixel art of a bedrock and a dragon egg. And, by the way, the dragon egg is indeed made out of obsidian. So, you guys remember, last episode we saw in the end, I dug out all the obsidian pillars. This is why. I made the whole thing out of obsidian, the dragon egg, because it looked better. So, yeah, this took a really, 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 really long time to build. Several weeks to build. And so, yeah, it looks really awesome. It almost looks surreal at some points. Like when you're flying around it. It almost looks like it's not real, but it definitely is real. And yeah, like I said, took an insane amount of time to build this in survival. Especially with all the obsidian there that I had to mine out. But anyway, that's the bedrock block with the dragon egg on top. I originally was going to build a Eye of Ender. Like an end portal frame with an Eye of Ender in it. To signify the end, but decided to go with this. Like I said, there used to be a 2x2 flush door here. But that has since broken. I'll fix that later on. But we also have something cool here. This is a 3x3 trapdoor, so there's actually a hole in the glass here that we have to fall down. So I just go ahead and jump off here. See, the trapdoor did not open properly. What the heck? Come on now. Come on now, thing. Dagnabbit. Why not? Come on, guy. Oh my god, guy. You fail me, guy. Alright, let's try this again. This might be why, actually. There's a block right there for some reason. What the heck? This should not be like this. What the world? One sec, guys. Let me fix this. this should work flawlessly. It was definitely working last time I checked. I think there was, for some reason, a block I left from when I was here last. Let's try that one more time. But basically, this leads down to our end portal area right here. Let me try this one more time just to show you guys it does work. It's a very fast 3x3, but it's almost at the limit of how fast you can make the 3x3. Without using zero tick stuff. So, it's quite quick. It's quite quick. And also we use sort of like instant repeaters, I think, on the way down, I believe, to power this. Let's try this one more time. Let's actually take off our elytra, just to be sure it's not that. So if I just fall straight down here, there we go. Success. Success. No, not success. What the heck? That's bogus. Oh my god. I'm pissed. Dang it. I think it might actually be opening and closing before. I don't even know. I honestly don't know. That's upsetting. That's upsetting. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on there. That's really weird. Anyway, I'll have to check that out. It might be because I'm recording. It might not be. I'm going to try it once more. Unfortunately, guys, I just really... I hate when I find stuff that breaks in the world. It's really upsetting that, like, stuff doesn't remain the same from version to version, but... That's Minecraft for you. That's Minecraft for you. I'm going to try it one more time just to make sure it doesn't work, but... It's looking like it doesn't for some reason. That's really weird. Let's try it again. Let's try it again. Alright, here we go. Right at the edge here. Let's jump in. Oh, there we go. Okay, I bounced back. Yeah, that time it worked. Okay, well, we'll see. We'll see. It might be latency. It might be a bunch of other factors. Something like that. Alright, let's get a little bit more enderpearl action going on here. We got the enderpearl dispenser here. Let's just move on. I think that does work. I think we just have to maybe jump before it. It's very precise timing, but anyway. Let's just get on with it. Let's go to the end. And let's see what else has broken. Eh? So, one of the things that is broken in this world is actually the... I think I had a button there. Maybe not. Actually, the Enderman farm. So I'll go ahead and show you that. And the reason this broke is because mobs no longer spawn on pressure plates. And this is a pressure plate pusher design. So it's pretty much busted. It's not going to work. I have to redesign it totally. It does look pretty cool, though. Got the multicolored wool here. And actually, they removed the fog here in the end, if you guys didn't notice that. So it looks a lot better like when viewed from a distance. But unfortunately, that's all it is right now. Something that looks kind of cool when viewed from a distance. And I'm on outside of the water. Hooray! More stuff that's broken. Yay! So, this used to be the Enderman farm, which no longer works. You can see, yeah, there was evidence of Endermen who once spawned here, but they no longer do. I'm just going to go ahead and pick these up. Why not? Could definitely use them. Get rid of some of the other stuff in my inventory. Put that on. There we go. Alright. So, and then this basically used to raise this, and that would prevent the Enderman from dying on via fall damage. But that is all since broken, so we have to make a new Enderman farm, basically. And the only other thing I have here is, yeah, enchantment table, anvil, and some Enderman banners, along with some other stuff. What's this? Oh, oak leaves. Old oak leaves. Looks like. Let's test them out. Yeah, old oak leaves. Hilariously huge block model for the win. Anyway, that's what we got there. And yeah, other just random stuff. So that is something that needs to be fixed, along with a lot of other stuff in the world. But let's head back to the main end island. You guys have already seen this. And just a quick note on what this is, in case you guys are wondering who haven't seen this. This is where I went to the void and came back alive. We did that during a stream with some pigs. Looks like there is still a pig down there, by the way. Maybe. Nope, just a fence. Yeah, just a fence down there. But yeah, we went to the void for an extended period of time. Like, we spent like a minute, you know, several minutes in the void, and then came back alive. So it is possible to go to the void and come back alive, after staying down there for an extended period of time, in case you guys were wondering. Probably no one was wondering that, but I found it kind of interesting that you could do it. Anyway, let's go ahead and just make our way back. There's nothing else really in the end that I've done, besides, you know, go and explore a little bit out that direction. So we'll come back through, back out here, and now I say we go to the Nether, because there's more stuff in the Nether, some interesting stuff in the Nether. But before we do that, well, let's see, how do I want to do this? I think we'll go on one more quick minecart ride, and yeah, we'll go on one more quick minecart ride before going to the Nether and checking out the stuff in the far lands of the world. So we'll come on down here, and we will use our enderpearls to get down quickly, down to the hub. By the way, that symbol there coming down is similar to the London Underground, in case you guys were wondering. And so the other line we're going to go down, the zombie line, not really that interesting, to be honest. It goes out to close to where our second base is. The jungle line is somewhat interesting in some aspects. So we'll go ahead and head down here. So this comes out here, comes down, up and around. And yeah, jungle line, obviously. We got the jungle wood on top. This goes right by our village breeder right there. Villager breeder, I should say. And again, this is kind of a long minecart ride, but it's nice. You can sit back, relax. All the walls on these tunnels are all closed in. So they're covered in with glass, or just, you know, barreled through the caves. So yeah, there's like glass there, so no mobs can get in. And it's all well lit. Bunch of torches, stuff like that. This also gave me a bunch of resources when I first dug these out, so that was kind of useful. So here's the first interesting thing here. We actually have a cart selector here. So we can go back home, go down the spider line, go down the expansion line, which literally ends right there, and then jungle line right here. So I'll go ahead and show you the spider line real quick, because it's the quickest. And this is a four-direction intersection, by the way. So it's kind of a nice four-direction intersection. This is just a very basic spider spawner. That's all this is. Right here. So you can turn the lights on and off. And the spiders all fall down into the water streams here and then are transported up here. This is one of the first mob farms I ever built. And it still works, obviously. But yeah, it should be spawning some mobs. And this is actually the reason why this I built the giant spider in Zerzera is partially because it's right underneath the spider spawner. So we're actually in Zerzera now, where we're at. So that gives you a sense of where we're at. And yeah, by now I think, yeah, some spiders have spawned and they should be making their way up the spider elevator over to right here where we can just reach in here and just slam. Just take them out right here. Yep, here he comes. And then just boom. They're not one hit or anything. It's just a very basic farm, but it still works, which is better than most farms that are this old. So then we come over here. This is a little minecart station. This line doesn't go anywhere. I think this... Which one is the button to launch me? I think this one. Yeah. Yep, cool. So that's just a little two-way intersection. We'll come back down here to the four-way intersection. And we have kind of an interesting jungle line here. So we'll go ahead and head down here. Now, some stuff's going to happen here really quickly. So there's actually a slime block launcher cart selector right here. So basically if I hit the note block or not determines if I go on the top or the bottom rail, and they both go to different places. So you see the flashing thing? Let's just hit this right there. So it took us to the bottom one, and this goes to our quintuple cave spider spawner. So that's five cave spider spawners all within range, with spawning range. And here it is. This is one of the more recent episodes as well. And basically how this works, you see I sort of changed up here since last time. Last time you guys saw this. But basically if I stand, let's see, right here, yeah. You see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spawners activated. And then I can just go ahead and turn off the lights in there. And we can have 5 cave spider spawners all going at the exact same time. And they all collect right in here. There's a series of water streams down below. They all push them underneath here. And they all collect up right here. Which is very nice, very useful. This is how I get a lot of string. See, string and spider eyes collect in here after I slay them. And the XP actually comes out here. So we should see relatively soon here some spiders collecting up in here, I believe. Yeah, so none in there quite yet. They're all filtering their way through. There they are. Yep. And then we just hit them, and there we go. RIP. And then, yeah, we just keep slaying them here. And so this is a good way to get XP. You see the XP comes through, and they can't hit us here, actually, because of this upside-down stair. And, yeah. Then we just keep slaying here and get as much string and XP as we want. So there we go. That's what that is all about. And then, of course, you know, the string and stuff. You see the string coming in here. And spider eyes, they all automatically get put in here via hoppers and a dropper elevator below. We also have a rudimentary enchantment table. So this basically works. You can add different numbers of bookshelves here. You can add 8 bookshelves. You can add 5 bookshelves. No bookshelves or all bookshelves. So, yeah, another just small thing there. And that's it for this portion of the line. And when we come back here, we'll once again go over the slime block track switcher. So we go straight here and then forward here. And we'll just ride this out here. And then we'll come back this same way. Just to sort of demonstrate what happens if we don't hit the note block there on the side. So we'll go down the same line here. Jungle line. Of course, I could have just gotten out and just, you know, started back going the opposite way. But, you know, whatever. So this time we're not going to hit the note block here. So we're just going to leave it. See the track flashes. We're going to get launched here. Boom, up to the second one, and now we're on a different line. So that is the slime block track switcher. That's how that works. And this will actually take us out to the jungle, to the charged creeper farm area. And so, make our way down here, and there we go. So now we're at the jungle area. You can see the charged creeper farm right out there, which I showed in one of the previous episodes. And then this line goes all the way out to a village, which is actually the nearest village to my base area. It's just a simple desert village. That's where I got most of my villagers from. So that is what we got there. So that is all that is. I'm just going to leave that there and fly back because it's actually much faster. Like I said, I don't use the minecart too much anymore. The minecart stuff too much anymore. So let's go ahead and make our way out here. Let's wait for this. I'm going to get up here and then I'm going to fly back this way. There we go. F5 mode. So we fly over Zara here. There we go. Alright. Alright, there's the flying machine parked at the balloon right there. Okay, so now I think we're done with the overworld for the most part. So now we can switch gears and we'll go to the Nether and some of the far reaches of the world. So, to get to the Nether, you step on these pressure plates, quad portal lights like that. There is a tutorial for this on my channel if you guys are interested. And we come to the Nether. So welcome to the Nether, guys. This is my Nether castle build. We got some details here, you know. We got, you know, different, like, blocks labeled here. Lava lamps, of course, around here. We also have enderpearl dispenser right here. I'll go ahead and put a few in there, actually. A couple of them in there. There we go. Beautiful. So, yeah, this is, like, the main area where you come in at. This is where the portal is. There's also, hoppers underneath here that collects those poppies from the golem farms. Some banners here, globe banners here. Over here we have pigman banner. We got stuff that I've just randomly stored around here. Some furnaces, very basic stuff. And then over here we have a nice little ice rink in the Nether. So if we go ahead and head up here, we got ourselves themed rooms. So this is a wither skeleton themed room. I'm missing the wither skeleton skull here though. Need to get one of those. This is the magma themed room, magma cube banners here of different designs, and there's their drop. This one is the gas themed room, obviously a gas banner here, their drops and stuff right here, and then over here we have the blaze themed room, so blaze banners and their drop. That's what we got there. Up here we have just like a little office area up here, and we have some nice lookouts here. Have to be careful of ghasts though. Nice lookouts here over the surrounding areas. So that is what that is. And we have these little cubby holes here, basically. Now, in the center here, we have something kind of cool. This is actually a quick drop that leads to a treasure room. You can actually get to there from this third floor or the second floor. I'm just going to go right off here. And boom, we are in the treasure room. We did have the option of bouncing back up and getting off at the first floor if we wanted to there, but I chose not to and stayed down in the treasure room. But you can indeed go from the third floor to the first or the second to the first via this drop, and then, yeah, arrive safely at the first floor up there. But let's take a look at the Nether treasure room. So this is where I keep a lot of ores and resources. Apparently, we have some that need to be put away from when I built this a long time ago. But yeah, we have ore blocks and like ore blocks over here, and then the mineral ores right here. And yeah, this actually on the ceiling actually spells out treasure in the standard galactic alphabet. That's what that is, in case you guys are wondering what that says. But that is that. Over here we have a little staircase leading up to a little park area that is outside of the Nether fort right here. And then, yeah, we also have string all the way around here because there's a block of string missing there, isn't there? Yes, there is. Put that down there. Because ghasts cannot see through the string. So this is actually gas defense, so to speak. It doesn't work all the time, but the vast majority of the time it'll work well. So if the gas is on the outside of this string force field, basically, they will not shoot at us. So that is a little bit of defense to prevent gas from getting us. But yeah, that's the Nether castle there. I can sort of show you what it looks like from afar here. We'll have to leave the confines of the string, the power of string. but there we go. Yeah, we got that. We have the ender crystals up there on top, which is a nice touch there. So that is the Nether castle, and of course we have quartz all surrounding this area here. Let's see, up here. Let's just make our way over this way. Over here, up that ladder right there, that leads to where I kill my withers at. Suffocate them in the bedrock, or actually capture them in the bedrock. So that's what that is. And then up here, we have a ender pearl elevator. So let me just go ahead and get up here. And this leads to the top of the Nether. There we go, top of the Nether. And this will lead us to our pigman farm. So if we just go ahead and slide on up here. We'll go up this ladder. It's a long way up here, but it's worth it. I don't think this design works as well as it once did. So this is the big donut design by, I believe, Snow Crash, which I built here in the world. I had to slightly modify his XP elevator because it wasn't really working anymore. So I've already modified that, but the actual design I think might be broken. So I might have to build the version 2 to get us all the gold. But basically, that's what this is, a gold farm. And you can see we have, you know, a bunch of materials here, some stuff there, some gold nuggets still waiting to be collected in there. And then up here is where we start the clock for the XP elevator. So that's going to start to move there. You can see that sort of how that works right there, pushing out the blocks. The redstone going right there. And then up here, this is where we have Stanley. Stanley the Pigman. He's just been hanging out here for like the last 2 years. Or however long I've had this. So we take one snowball, throw it at poor old Stanley here. Also, it's his job, hit by snowball. There we go. So then all the pigmen get aggravated. They all come to this point here, and then they fall to their death. And that's basically how it works. And we should see some XP coming up here, I believe. Yeah, here it comes. Comes right up here. There we go. Cool. And yeah, you see the problem here? The problem is the pigmen don't make their way over from these points here for some reason. So yeah, this is definitely broken, but you get the idea of how it used to work. It used to be amazing, but we need to get the new design going on nowadays. So, I'm going to go ahead and shut this down, and we will fly down from here, I think. Just jump off of here. Fly down to the bedrock floor. There's Pigman, RIP guy. RIP in peace. Or in pieces, I should say. To get down, we have a quick drop via cobwebs. Right there, cobwebs negate fall damage, so I use those instead of like a slime block or something, because you don't have to hit spacebar or anything. That leads us now to the witch farm, which is out this way. And before we do that, though, I want to check out the blaze farm and the ghost nether fortress over here. So the reason I have all these blocks here, in case you guys are wondering, is because this is actually what's called a ghost fortress. It's a fortress that exists in the game, but due to a bug in 1.6.4, I believe, my nether fortress bounding box should have been bigger than it was, or something to that effect. Like, basically, the bounding box was really weird. And so, basically, the game thinks there's a fortress here, but it wasn't generated or something like that. I think it was that the fortress became bigger and I wanted to expand the space available for withers to spawn on. I think that's what happened. But basically, this is where the fortress is. There's a ghast over there, dang it. Dang guy. So yeah, basically this is the fortress right here. This is a fortress, that's a fortress. All this is where wither skeletons can spawn. And speaking of spawning, we will get to the blaze spawners next time, right over here. Also, this is the portal to our end area right here. That's why I have the end banners up. That's where the big portal in the dark in the dragon egg room ends up. But yeah, next time we'll take a look at the blaze farms, and we'll take a look at the witch farm and hopefully the guardian farm and some other areas that are far off in the world. Anyways, guys, hopefully you're still enjoying the world tour. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Cub. Goodbye.